Come on, folks.
We're moving.
Little more gently, love. I'll walk. We're by myself. You don't need
thank
to
touch.
Never touch.
Thank you.
Did you just shove me in the back?
Three, seven, five, six.
I just said don't shove me, and the man just deliberately shoved me while I was moving away.
It won't make any difference to me.
Two now.
So you currently join us. I keep losing my live stream as we're in this melee of people. Police have decided they want to block our view. And because they want to block our view, they're moving us out of the way. We were reluctant to go because there's no purpose to this vehicle going in there. There's already plenty of cops in there. There's absolutely no purpose to this other than to obscure the public viewing police activities. And that is wrong. You know, these are a public service.
One rule for the other.
What a waste of our police force. What a shit way to treat them and us. What, 3, 7, 5, 6? Yeah, I agree. I said to him, there's no need to push me. I'm moving. 3, 7, 5, 6 then jabbed my back deliberately.
I'll push you, violence.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Yes, but that's the point. They're pushing us in the wrong way. Not just physically, but emotionally.
Don't get personal.
Now, how do you know that?
They do lean in tight.
I've heard a rumour. Seen on Facebook.
Been tweeting about it all night.
There is no room to observe around the... I'm going to go the other side and prove there's no way to observe. Right, so we're told now by the police that we can observe from the other end. But this we know to be a lie because the other end is full of cops. And again, we're being obscured from witnessing our friends and the people we stand with. They have poor welfare. There's only 4 people in there for 13 in a lock-on. That's inadequate for welfare provision. 2 of them are in wheelchairs. They require their own individual welfare officer. That means that leaves just 2 to manage the other 11. Right, I have got a better view over this bonnet. The protection removal team, or they call it protester removal team, is in there. They came earlier today and worked out how to remove, yeah, what sort of lock-ons they were. We know that the lock-ons themselves, the equipment used was very strong and the fillings are strong. Ambulance coming through! Of course, the ambulance can't get through because the police have made this single lane. For no reason, they've made it single lane. It wasn't us all morning until the police got here. There wasn't a single incident. All traffic flowed. The police came, made it single lane so that they could hide what they're doing. I understand keeping people back for safety reasons when there's cutting equipment, cutting people out, but it certainly doesn't need to be by sealing off the road. Risking 999 vehicles. This is a blue light road. We treat it with respect, but the police don't seem to. So we've got a clear run, it always does. Oh, sorry.
Don't be so loud, don't you?
You know me so well. I know you weren't for the police. I want someone to kill in 96 years or something.
It's your opinion, it's your
opinion. It's opinion. It's fact. I am. It's fact. I'm not you. I'm not you.
So you can see the protester removal team is now taking details from each of the lock-ons. As I say, there are 13 local people locked on, 3 councillors, 2 people in wheelchairs. 11 of the 13 have never done an action like this in their lives. All are law-abiding locals. And now the protester removal team is going to go and take their details. Each of them will be arrested. What you'll see in the press today is that the local pro fracking group, it's very small, called Lancashire for Shale, does not believe that we do this because we do act with honour, responsibility for our children, and that this to us is obligation, which is why we've all been awake for over 24 hours, why these people are putting themselves through it. So Lancashire for Shale has been putting out in the press that they believe that we are all paid professional activists, that for every day we're here, we're paid. Where they get this information from, we don't know. We'd love to see proof. Most of us are completely poverty-stricken as a result of our activism. And I think that they should be made to prove what they're claiming, because it's an absolute lie. There's a film out later today. We had a small film crew come with us through the planning of this operation, through the briefing meetings, through the dry runs, and they filmed each of the individual lock-on locals, and they've spoken to each of them individually and filmed each of them. And these are the faces you see every day at Preston New Road. It's not like they just turned up for this. These are the faces you see on all the live streams on a regular basis. I like that the ice cream van doesn't beep his horn, but he plays his tune.
Scumbags.
She's an individual. She's not the one that's still doing that.
You're all stood here. Oh, no. You're not individuals. You're one collective. You're an individual.
Sorry, left. Just got to change areas. I'm going to come off this live stream and come back on in a sec. So...